That was smooth. One more topic for the night, man. We ended it off with this Diddy shit. Did you see TD Jakes? You know TD Jakes?
Oh, man, I just seen something on that.
Bro.
TD Jakes, the pastor.
My aunties look up to this TD Jakes. I always was like, auntie, you tripping.
They're tripping. There's something about TD Jakes that just ain't
man,
all.
Look.
When I was young, that's all they would talk about is TD Jakes.
Look,
TD
man.
Jakes.
You got to know how this thing works. Like, once you know how this thing works, yeah, man, you can just see through it. And he's one of those cases of like, I just saw through it early. You feel me? But bring him to the stage, man. You front and center, TD.
He used to have them bangers, though, them songs.
Look at this right here. You about to be, you look, I had to say this for the finale.
Hold up, who that, the security guard? Hold up, what?
That's why I'm gonna be going to the coffee place.
Hi, 50. See how I wrap that in?
The front and the back at the same time.
This is science, people.
What are you talking about? Look, if you're into that, you're into that, I'm fine with it. It's your song. I'm just saying this ain't my motherfucking kind of party. I like it. It's uncomfortable. I think I belong in the girls' bathroom. And shit like that is going on.
I lived with Sean Puffy Combs for a year.
That's the crazy thing. Now, that was L.A. Reid's idea, right? We're sending
New
you over
York
to
City.
Something called Puffy Flavor Camp.
There you go.
To learn
Flavor
some...
Camp.
Yeah,
Flavor
that's
camp.
What it was called. And you're going to go to Puff Daddy's. He's going to...
Yo, Dub, you going to Flavor Camp?
Absolutely not.
He said absolutely not.
Can't go to
Flavor. Oh, my gosh. You going to Flavor Camp? Nah.
90s. Do you understand what that's like?
Puffy's was like just filled with chicks and orgy.
You know what I'm saying?
Right?
No, not really. I mean, it was curious. I got a chance to see some things.
Yeah, but you were 13. What were you seeing?
I went there to see the lifestyle.
Right.
And I saw it. And it was. But I don't know if I could indulge and understand what I was even.
Now, why would you say you don't know if you could indulge or understand? What is there to understand if you understand? Like, because you're taught that in school, right? Regular, relations and such. So
you're
like
just
what?
Not sleeping in the bed with another grown man at 13. You ain't scared of the dark.
On top of whatever he saw going
Unless
on
Usher
between
was
grown men.
Of the dark,
it was some activities
looking
going
at.
On.
It was pretty wild.
You're a dad now. Would you ever send your kid to Puffy Camp?
Hell no.
And you so-called modern church. Go ahead.
And that's key. You would not send your child where you went. Come on,
and,
man.
And you were successful.
That's very telling.
But you were successful on top of that.
And it came out that you know what I'm saying, were kind of sick for real. So it's you know what I mean? Yeah,
you look just like the center. You act just like the center.
That's right.
And you think just like the center.
That's right.
This is wild.
That's right.
That's why you find TD Jakes hanging out with Puff Daddy.
Yeah.
With him?
No, he would
head
come from New
shoulder.
York to L.A. He,
oh, I see.
And I couldn't even get in the club because he was so famous. And not right now, Fox Diddy in here. So one day I flipped it on him and showed up in a town. It was town car days. I had a town car. Popped out the town car with a camera. Said, yo, Puff, yo, you got to let me film this. The whole thing. We need to document this, Playboy. He was like, yo, let him through. And I'm like, all right, I'm through. And I had the big Canon camera. It wasn't like this.
Sure, yeah.
You know, so I had the big Canon camera with the light and... battery, yo, do that again, Puff. And so I started hanging out with Puff like back in the day. And I know this story don't make sense, but it's gonna make sense. I would hang out and watch him throw parties.
Sure, he famously threw his white party out.
Well, he would throw a party. One point I went to Philly, followed him all the way to Philly. He threw a party and he said, yo, Playboy, this party costs $1.5 million.
To throw.
I'm like, you are out of your mind. And I said, Puff, I'll throw you a party for $400. That
Word.
That will rival this party. Mm-hmm. And he got pissed at me. He said, yo, don't play with me. You know who I am. I'm Diddy. You know what I'm saying? I said, no, I'm not. I respect you. But in L.A., I'm known for throwing, like, these cool little parties. So he came to L.A. in my modest little home. He showed up. Well, he called, like, Saturday morning. Yo, Playboy, I'm in town. Make it happen. I said, cool. So I went into my little phones. Sure. Called about 200 of the coolest people. They all came to my house. Puff showed up with, you know, SUVs and FBI. It was just, you know, it was crazy. And, you know, because it was, you know, it was all, Puff was always sort of dangerous, you know, so he had all kinds of people following. So,
when Jamie Foxx was hospitalized earlier this year, there were so many rumors and conspiracies going around surrounding what happened to him because the family at the time only revealed that he had a medical emergency. The biggest conspiracy was tied to Diddy. That he allegedly put a hit on Jamie Foxx. And this is because of some old videotapes that Jamie Foxx had. He's spoken out a few times about recording some of the wild parties that Diddy had back in the day. So at the time, it seemed a bit far-fetched to me that that would be the reason why for him to
seemingly put a hit on
Jamie. These parties happened years ago. But then Cassie came out and a few others. So to me, the timing of all of this and just the commonalities between the stories is starting to look a bit interesting.
Anybody thinks I owe him some, show me the receipt. You get paid in 24 hours.
The settlement comes one day after word of the lawsuit was filed where she accused him of sexual assault.
Speaking of Cassie, Christian Key said that she was the inspiration for him coming out to tell his story. Not the entire story, but most of the story. Unless you've been living under a rock, I'm sure you've heard of the allegations that
he just came out recently.
Producer Christian Keys brought forth to his many followers on Instagram and to the world, basically, regarding a
not just girls but dudes
harassed
bro.
Him in an inappropriate manner for years on end, and he's just basically speaking up.
It's
and
crazy.
He's tired. Based on what he said, a large portion of the population is thinking that he's speaking on Tyler Perry. And I must admit, a lot of the clues that he said, everything that he was saying, pointed towards Tyler Perry. In really the video, does. He also stated that if he were to reveal who said person is, it would break our hearts because he's held up as a beloved figure in the community. I don't find it shocking. I'm not saying that it's true. However, if it is true, I don't think it's shocking. I just found it interesting, you know, the ties, all the connections within the industry. And when I say industry, I'm not talking about just, you know, the movie industry. However, if it is true, I don't think it's shocking. I just found it interesting.
Look at these people. Look at Tyler and this dude. Tyler looked zesty as I don't know what in that picture. No offense to the zesty people.
I mean, he did say he felt more comfortable as Madea than Tyler Perry.
Like, you can just, and then, like, just his, and then, low-key, the way he holding Diddy hand, but we ain't gonna talk about that. Yeah, man. Madness, crazy. Bro. Madness.